Stock markets are anticipating an exit for Greece from the Eurozone. So today we will discuss how Germany have said not only will they need a third bailout, but a fourth and fifth and more. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Today we're going to get into Greece and then connect that in with the US. Let's begin with this here, a little bit of humor. And the title for this picture was actually when your banana guy is telling you which stocks to trade, you know we are at the bubble's peak. And isn't it really interesting when you talk to people who aren't really familiar with the stock market, but they are so confident in what they're doing, all because of their investment in it. Of course, if you're going to put all of your money into something, you definitely want to believe in it. That's what I see happening right now. But let's get into the big news of the day, beginning with this. One of Greece's largest banks will wipe away the debts and freeze the mortgages of clients who owe up to 20,000 euros in a move designed to ease the burden on its crisis-hit customers. This is actually something I never would have expected to occur. This is really small in comparison to the larger crisis that is happening now, but very interesting to say the least. This is one of the country's major four banks here decided to write off or restructure debts in response to the humanitarian crisis through which its poorest clients were living. This is according to the company's own statement here. Very interesting to note this information that there was sort of some forgiveness on the debt, not in part by the government itself, but by the bank. So I'm not sure what the deeper meaning of this is. I don't expect all debts to be wiped away for the citizens, that's for sure, but this is very unique to have been occurred in the recent past, where they would always bail out the banks and never protect the individual. So I want to keep closer attention on this and see where it really goes if this actually does occur. This is a translated article out of a German newspaper, and what we are looking at is a government official being asked a few questions. So bear in mind, this is not exactly the greatest translation. I was just using the Google Translate, but we'll get the point across. Has Greece yet more billions? There is a third rescue package for Athens. Right here, obviously just asking if there's going to be a third round of bailouts. What he said, 4 months, politicians pressed the public for a clear answer, but a member of parliament has now had enough. And he said, Athens needs many aid packages. Right here, we need citizens to come clean. If Greece is going to stay in the euro, there will not only need to be a third bailout package, but also a fourth, fifth, and even more. See, now it's not those in the alternative news or even those in the mainstream media saying this. It is many different high-level officials that are coming out and suggesting that Greece needs to be bailed out over and over and over again. But why exactly is that the case if only a couple years ago they were saying that everything was under control? Well, when you submit to the Troika, when you have all of these government agencies basically pulling and tearing at every corner, you're going to be left with nothing. They don't have any sovereignty remaining whatsoever, and this is the result of that. Continuous bailouts. Every single bailout needs another bailout to follow it. So it says that if Greece should remain in the euro, then we must clearly say the country safe for decades then need our help. Obviously a poor translation, but essentially what they're saying is they're going to need assistance from Germany, from the EU, from the IMF, whoever it might be, if they want to stay in. Now, the EU wants them to stay under their stronghold for the same reasons why they were put in there in the first place. This is all about control. This is all about a tyrannical rule. That has nothing to do with trade or, some suggest on the other end of the spectrum, with isolationism. Because you can trade, you can have agreements with other countries, and you don't need to shut down, or I should say open up your borders to allow this to happen. You could have trade that does occur at such a great level. They don't need all of this unity in this way. They can have unity in between the countries with different types of agreements. So a good article here to look at, although the translation, as I said, was poor. This is what I wrote about in my book. I predicted it. And here it is. A second round of bailouts for Greece is needed. So this was written just prior to Greece needing that second round. And then I said, despite the billions given during the first round, it wasn't enough it will continue. So obviously what I'm saying here is that they're going to need more than two bailouts. It's not enough, a second round. I knew that from day one, and anyway, everyone does anyway. As soon as you get bailed out once, you're going to need more, because that's just the way it works. Just like an alcoholic needs just one more drink, just like that gambler needs to play just one more hand, it always works in this way. But it's not the fault of the individual citizens there. It is those bankers who put them under the credit default swaps and made their country poor so that they are forced into this scheme. Many different countries have had to submit to the IMF, to things like the Troika, where you have a set of technocratic elite making the decisions for their own country, which we all have fraudulent voting, but here it is. You don't even need voting if you're in the EU because they make all the rules. Now, we're going into this article here, which is very serious, in fact. The German finance minister hinted on Saturday that Berlin will be preparing for a possible Greek default, drawing a parallel with the secrecy of German reunification plans in 1989. This is very important information here, because we're dealing with a Greek default would obviously set off a chain reaction. The dominoes will fall, as I've always said. At a briefing with reporters after a tense meeting of the Eurozone finance ministers on Greece on Friday, he was asked if the Eurozone finance ministers were working on a, quote, plan B in case negotiations of funding with cash-strapped Athens fail. And they are, in fact, working on that plan B. They did say that it is affirmative. So this is very important to note, that many countries have now prepared for the possibility of Greece needing to go and claim bankruptcy. This is very huge information, and it is obviously very serious because of the global implications. Now, speaking of global implications, I want to stretch this out into the US. We always look to the US as a sign of basically a strong economy and strong GDP growth at all times, though, you know, there are times of weaker growth and stronger growth. Overall, it is seen as a strong nation. But look at this right here. Since the 1950s up until today, we have a slow and steady decline into negative territory. What we're looking at is a serious situation here, because the US was always seen, at least from post-World War II, as the engine of growth for the entire global economy. The US consumer was there to buy up everything and keep everything going. But now, today, that really, truly isn't the case. We're looking at numbers here that are actually so entirely fraudulent, and this is bad, using their own numbers. We're looking at negative GDP when you factor in so many other things, but even using their own numbers, we can see the trend line moving downward. The jobs have been shipped overseas, and there is nothing for this to stand on whatsoever. I'm going to move on quickly here. And we're looking at this. There are many different indicators that I've always gone through, the different charts, and this happens to be one of those. We're looking at earnings versus sales, and you could see that in the previous two crashes, we have encountered this same type of downward spin here, and we have entered the same thing today. So this is very crucial information, because we are entering a time in which we're hitting the Lehman crisis era once again. This happens to be yet another time. Let's begin with this one here, seeming like we're heading into the exact same pattern once again. 394 weeks, 7.5 years, where the same exact pattern has occurred. And this is very frightening, because look at how high the stock market has come in these few years, and it always is the case that it drops much faster than it rises. We could see a dead cat bounce. We could see any of these different technical terms here. It doesn't matter. The fact remains is that we are headed for a crash. Now, if you saw my last video on the Fukushima radiation and the GMOs, I just wanted to add this in at the very end, because it is connected. And Japanese authorities have detected an unusually high level of radiation around a playground equipment in a Tokyo park. This is actually very frightening here, because the radiation is finding its way and spreading all around, not just, you know, towards the towards the east, but also within Japan, of course, on its own. The incident comes days after a drone with traces of radiation landed on top of the Prime Minister's office. This is obviously a sign that people are fed up with the situation with Fukushima. Obviously, this is very threatening to the health of the people, not just in Japan, but all around the world. So that's all I wanted to just add to the previous video I had done. If you found this video informative, please give me a thumbs up. And don't forget to become a subscriber on here. It's very important. We are headed towards 20,000 subscribers, and I hope that if you're not already, you'll join me on there. Last but not least, don't forget to become an insider. It's where I give out all my best intel for free, and that is available at themoneygps.com. All you have to do is scroll down to the bottom, fill in your email address, and you get occasional emails from me with good, short, concise info.